Hello friends, my name is Vaseem and I welcome you all to this channel Bank for You. So friends, in this video we shall discuss the second model from the topic of number system, which is based on the concept of consecutive numbers. So consecutive numbers are those numbers which come one after the other at regular intervals. So there are various types of consecutive numbers. Let us first understand these and let us take some examples based on them. So the first one here is consecutive natural numbers. So these are called as consecutive natural numbers. So consecutive natural numbers are those natural numbers which come one after the other, and this can be represented as x, x plus 1, x plus 2, x plus 3 and so on. That means if the first number is x, then the second consecutive number or the second consecutive natural number is x plus 1, then x plus 2, then x plus 3, x plus 4 and so on. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4. So these are consecutive natural numbers. Why? Because we find that these are all in a row. So 1, 2, 3, 4 without any gap. So these are all called consecutive natural numbers, or this can be called as successive numbers. Similarly, 83, 84, 85 and 86. Even these are consecutive natural numbers or successive numbers. And if you can see here, the first number is taken as x. If this first number is taken as x, then x plus 1 is 83 plus 1. X plus 1 is 83 plus 1, that is 84. X plus 2 is 85. So 85 will be here. Then x plus 3 will be 83 plus 3 will be 86 and so on. So whenever we solve questions related to consecutive numbers, we should take the first number as x, then the second number is x plus 1, then third number would be x plus 2 and so on, depending upon the number of consecutive numbers that we have here. The second one here is consecutive even numbers. Now we have already understood that what are even numbers. Even numbers are those numbers which are exactly divisible by 2 or which are exact multiples of 2. So whenever we have even numbers in a row without any gap, then such numbers are called consecutive even numbers. For example, 2, 4, 6, 8. So all these are consecutive even numbers, and these even numbers can be represented as x, x plus 2, x plus 4, x plus 6 and so on. That means the first number is x. That means the first number is x should be even here. So the first number x has to be even here. So the next number should be x plus 2, that is x plus 2 would be, the previous number plus 2. So the third one has to be x plus 4, fourth one will be x plus 6 and so on. And remember, the first number x should be even here. The first number x has to be even here. So if you take any even number, the first number x has to be even. So if you take any even number in place of x, then x plus 2, x plus 4, x plus 6 will give us consecutive even numbers. For example, 68 is here, 68, 70, 72 and so on. If the first number is x, that is 68, then 68 plus 2. If this is the first number x, then 68 plus 2 is 70. So is the next even number. So then 68 plus 4 is 72. So will here be the third even number and so on. So the point to be observed here is in between two consecutive even numbers, the difference is always 2. So plus 2. So see here, plus 2 will give the next one. Again, plus 2 will give, plus 2 will give us the next one. Again, plus 2 will give the third one here and so on. So that is the reason if the first number is x, then the next number should be taken with the addition of 2. Again, the third number has to be taken with the addition of 2 to get the fourth number here. Right? To get the fourth number here. And so on. So x, x plus 2, x plus 4, x plus 6 forms consecutive even numbers provided that the first number is x is even. So even 2, 4, 6, 8 is also the consecutive even numbers. Likewise, we also have consecutive odd numbers. Consecutive odd numbers are odd numbers in a row. For example, 1, 3, 5, 7 can be treated as consecutive odd numbers. Why? Because we see they all are coming one after the other in succession. So these are successive odd numbers, or we can call consecutive odd numbers. Now consecutive odd numbers also represented as x, x plus 2, x plus 4, x plus 6 and so on, where x is odd. So x has to be odd here. So even in consecutive odd numbers can be taken as x, x plus 2, x plus 4, x plus 6 and so on. That means the difference between two consecutive odd numbers is always 2. So plus 2 will give the next number, plus 2 plus 2 will give the next number, that is the third number, plus again for the third number, plus 2 will give the fourth number and so on. For example, 33, 35, 37. So these are three consecutive odd numbers. The first number x is 33, then the next x plus 2, that is 33 plus 2, will give the next number, that is 35, and x plus 4, that is 33 plus 5, 4, 37 gives the next odd number and so on. So the point to be observed here is the consecutive even and consecutive odd numbers are always represented as x, x plus 2, x plus 4 and so on, where x is even in case of consecutive even numbers and x is odd in case of consecutive odd numbers. And always the difference between the consecutive even or consecutive odd numbers is equal to 2. I hope you understood this concept of model 2, that is consecutive numbers, that is natural numbers, consecutive even numbers and consecutive odd numbers. Let us take the first example here based on the concept of consecutive numbers here. As you can see, the question here is the sum of 4 consecutive even numbers is 44. What is the sum of the original squares of these numbers? So see here, it is talking about what? The sum of 4 consecutive even numbers. It is talking about the even numbers, right? So because it is talking about the even numbers, we already know that. So whenever we are going to take the consecutive even numbers, the first number would be x, the second number would be x plus 2, then the third one would be x plus 4, the next one would be x plus 6. So the sum of all these 4 numbers is equal to 44 here, right? So because the sum, it is talking about the sum, I am going to add up all this here, right? So the sum of 4 consecutive even numbers, that is x, x plus 2, x plus 4, x plus 6 is equal to 44 here. So when we are going to add this 1, 2, 3, 4, there are 4x plus, so 2 plus 4 is 6, 6 plus 6 is 12, is equal to 44 here. So 4x is equal to, if you are going to transfer this plus 12 to the other side, this becomes minus 12. So 4x is equal to 44 minus 12 is equal to 32. So x is equal to 32 divided by 4, that is equal to 8. So x is equal to 8 here. So because x is equal to 8 here, I can certainly say that x plus 2, x plus 4, x plus 6 would be, so 8 plus 2 is equal to 10, 8 plus 4 is equal to 12, so 8 plus 6 is equal to how much? It is 14, right? So it is talking about what? I mean, these are the original numbers, right? So now what it is talking about, what we are supposed to do, what is the sum of the original squares of these numbers? So the original squares of these 4 numbers has to be found out. That is, 8 square is equal to 64. So 10 square is equal to 100. So 10 square is equal to 100. 12 square is equal to 144. 14 square is equal to 196. So we need to take the sum of all this. So 4 plus 4 is 8. 8 plus 6 is equal to 14. 4 is here. 1 is carried forward. So 1 plus 6 is 7. 7 plus 4 is 11. So 11 plus 9 is 20, 0 is here, 2 is carried forward, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the sum would be equal to 504 here. So the sum of these 4 numbers is equal to 504. But then, let me tell you friends, if you are well versed in the concept of averages, you need not to put this step here. So directly you can find this value. So directly you can find this value and you can go ahead. So to find out these 4 even numbers, you need not to put all these and you need not to find it out. But because we have not done the concept of averages here, so I'm going to do it in this way. So we shall see to it once again when we are going to see the concept of averages. I hope you understood. Let's check out the second example from the model 2 here. So the product of two successive numbers is 4692. So what is the smaller of the two numbers? So it is talking about the small, we need to find out the smaller of the two numbers, right? So the product of two successive numbers, it is talking about the two successive numbers. So it is not talking about the two successive even numbers or odd numbers. It is talking about only the successive numbers. So therefore, if you are going to take the first number as x, the next number has to be x plus 1. So the product of these two has to be 4692. So the product means x into x plus 1 is equal to 4692. So therefore, if you multiply this, x into x would be x square plus x into 1 is x. So if you are going to bring this to this side, this becomes minus 4692 is equal to 0 here. So see here, if you look at this, so it's a quadratic equation, friends. So because it's a quadratic equation, it may take so much time for us to solve this. So because it is going to take so much of time to solve this, so I don't suggest you to go through this method. So we can eliminate the wrong options here. So it is talking about what is the smaller of the two numbers. The smaller of the two numbers has to be found out, right? So see here, the product would be 4692. If you go by unit digit method here, so see here, so the smaller any of these four numbers would be smaller of, I mean, one of these four would be, I mean, I think one of these four would be the answer. So therefore, I can certainly say that if this is x, because it is talking about the smaller, right? So if this is x, the next one has to be x plus 1. That is 69 plus 1 would be 70. So here the unit digit is 9. The unit digit here is 0. So 9 into 0 would be 0. But at last, in the product, we have to get 2 here. But then because we are not getting 2 here, this cannot be the answer. The next one is 62 here. So 62 into 63. The next one has to be 63, right? Sorry for this. The next one has to be 63. Because this is the smaller, right? So 2 into 3. So 2 and 3 are the unit places. So 2 into 3 is equal to 6. At last, I mean, the product of these two would be 6. I mean, in the units place, it would be 6. But it has to be 2 here. But then, so because it is not 2 here, so this cannot be the answer. The next one is 68. If this is the 68 is x, the x plus 1 would be 69. So 69. So 8 into 9. Unit digits are 8 and 9. 8 into 9 are 72, right? So because 8 into 9 are 72, I am going to take 2 in the units place, right? 8 into 9 is 72. 2 would be at the units place. So, but in the product is also it is 2. So therefore, this can be the answer. But then I cannot certainly say that this will be the answer. Why? Because so we have further options as well. So because of that reason, I cannot come to a conclusion that this would be the answer. So the product, the last two digits product, I mean unit place product, may be 2 in the different options also. So therefore, this may not be the answer, but then this can be the answer as well. Let's take the next one. 67 into 68. So 7 into 8 is 56, right? 56. So at the units place, it would be 6. So therefore, this cannot be the answer as well. So already we have eliminated 3 options. So either option 3 has to be the answer or 4 has to be the answer. But then if you are going to multiply 68 with 69, so you will be getting 4692. So therefore, 4692 has to be the answer. That is nothing but option 3 here. I hope you got it. So remember, whenever you get these kind of questions, so do not attempt to solve with the help of quadratic equations, as this is too much, it is going to consume too much of your time, right? So that is why I'm not going to suggest you the method of quadratic equations. So the smart way is this. So, and remember one thing, so you may get 2 in the units place in more than one options. You may get 2 in the units place in more than one options. But then if you're getting 2 in the units place in more than one options, at that particular point of time, you have to verify both the options. That means you have to multiply these two and then only you can go ahead. Otherwise, you should not go ahead. So this you need to understand. So sorry for this. This has to be example 2. The next one is, we shall take up the next example here. That is example 3. So this is example 3. Okay. The question here is, the sum of 5 consecutive even numbers is 200. So what is the sum of the next set of consecutive even numbers. So see here, it is talking about what? The sum of 5 consecutive even numbers is 200. 5 consecutive even numbers, it is talking about even numbers. So let the first number be x, the next one number would be x plus 2, then x plus 4, then x plus 6 and x plus 8 is equal to 200. It is talking about the sum, right? So therefore we have to put plus here. So 5x, if you are going to add this, this would be 5x plus, so 2 plus 4 is 6, 6 plus 6 is 12, 12 plus 8 is 20 is equal to 200. So 5x is equal to, so 200 minus 20, because if you are going to transfer this 20 to the other side, this becomes minus 20. So x is equal to 180 divided by 5. If you transfer this 5 to the other side, this goes to the denominator. So therefore x is equal to 36 is the answer here, right? So x is 36. So x is 36. So x plus 2 is equal to 38. So x plus 4 is equal to 40. So x plus 6 is equal to 42. And x plus 8 is equal to 44 here, right? So now it is asking what is the sum of the next set of consecutive even numbers. So we need to find out the sum of next set of consecutive even numbers. That means the next set would be, so after 44, the next one would be 46. Then next one would be 48, 50, 52 and 54 here. So we need to take up the sum of all these. So therefore 54 plus 46. 54 plus 46 would be 100. 52 plus 48 is also 100. So 100 plus 100 is 200. 200 plus 50 would be 250. So the answer has to be 250 here. But remember one thing. So we know to put all these and we know to solve this question, friends. Why? Because so if you are smart enough to do it, so you can make it very easily without putting all this here. So the best way is, see here. So let us take the 5 consecutive even numbers. So 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. So the next set of consecutive even numbers would be, it is 12, 14, 16, 18 and 20. So if this sum is A equal to A, the next sum has to be equal to A plus 50. Why I have told you A plus 50 means, so see here, the difference between 2 and 12 is plus 10, right? So the next one is, the next difference is between 4 and 14 would be plus 10. Again, between 6 and 16 would be plus 10 again. Between 8 and 18, again plus 10. The next one would be 10 and 20. The difference would be plus 10 again. So therefore, in each of these sets, so the difference is 10 here. So therefore, 10 plus 10, 20. 20 plus 10 is 30. 30 plus 10 is 40. 40 plus 10 would be 50. So therefore, A plus 50 has to be the answer here. I hope you got it. Again, if you look at here also, so 36 plus, the difference between 36 and 46 is 10. So the difference between 38 and 48 is also 10. So the difference between 40 and 50 is also 10. The difference between 42 and 52 is also 10. The difference between 54 and 44 is also 10 itself. So therefore, 10 plus 10, 20. 20 plus 10 is 30. 30, 40, 50. So therefore, the sum of these 5 consecutive even numbers is equal to 200. So the next number has to be 250. I hope you got it. Again, see here, don't get confused here. Whenever it is asked that, for example, so there are first 4 consecutive even numbers. If we need to find out the sum of the next set of 4 consecutive even numbers, it cannot be 40. Why it cannot be 40? So because, see here, this rule is applicable for odd numbers also. Because this rule is applicable for odd numbers also, I'm going to take the first 4 odd numbers. So 1, 3, 5 and 7. So the next set of odd numbers would be, see here, that is 9, then it is 11, 13 and 15. It is 15, right? So the difference here is, so plus 8, again the difference, 11 minus 3 is also plus 8. 13 minus 5 is also plus 8. Again, 15 minus 7 is also plus 8. So therefore, 8 into 4 is equal to 32. So therefore, if this is A, this has to be A plus 32. Right? So one similarity you have to understand here is, so if there are 5 numbers, then the difference would be 5 into 2, that is 10. If there are 4 consecutive numbers, then the difference has to be, so 4 into 2, that is equal to 8 here. So that is the basic logic which you have to understand, and based on that you have to solve the questions. I hope you understood this model 2 of the number system, that is the concept of consecutive numbers here. So this is all for today, friends. Thank you so much for watching. Have a good day ahead. Before ending up this session, I request you to subscribe to my channel, like the video, share the video with your friends, and if you have any doubts, please let us know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. Have a good day.